Hello! Today I'm going to show you how to backup virtual machines on standalone Hyper-V host using Ahsay OBM. Ahsay Backup provides total protection for all your guest VMs running on Hyper-V standalone or Hyper-V cluster hosts. Ahsay provides a wide range of technology to ensure data reliability, significant reduction in the amount of backup data transferred, and improved backup performance. Microsoft Volume Shadow Copy, a service that takes a snapshot of the guest VMs to ensure complete data consistency. Application Awareness on the Windows Guest VM, a feature that automatically flushes to the disk all data in memory and pending transactions to ensure application-level data consistency. Windows Resilient Change Tracking, or RCT, a technology that detects data block-level changes on a guest VM, which will only include in the backup data the data blocks that have changed since the last backup job. And combined with the automatic exclusion of swap file and deleted data blocks on the virtual disk, results in less backup data, less storage, and faster backup speeds. Using Ahsay OBM to backup whole guest VMs or individual virtual disks on Hyper-V allows you to restore the guest VMs to the original storage location on the same Hyper-V host, or restore to an alternate storage location on the same Hyper-V host. For advanced users, an option exists for manual recovery on the same Hyper-V host or a different Hyper-V host. Other recovery options are available, such as the use of granular restore to mount the virtual disk on a Windows guest VM directly from the backup file located on the backup destination, and run direct, a feature that allows you to run a virtual machine directly from the backup file located on the backup destination without the need to physically restore it on the Hyper-V host. Let's go to a standalone Hyper-V host and start to create a backup. On your standalone Hyper-V host, launch Ahsay OBM. Log in using your credentials. Click the Backup Sets tile and click on the plus icon to create a new backup set. Enter the name of your backup set, then select MS Hyper-V Backup as the backup set type. There are two versions available for the backup set type, the regular version and the failover cluster version. The failover cluster version is suited for backup sets that are set up in a cluster environment. Ahsay OBM will automatically detect the Hyper-V version and choose it as the default selection. For our example, we will leave it to the default selection, which is the regular version, as our current setup is a non-cluster environment. Click Next to proceed. Select the backup source. Select the guest VMs that you would like to backup. Click the plus icon beside the VM to open the drop-down menu if you want to individually select a virtual disk to backup. We will select the following VMs to backup. Click Next to proceed. Create an automatic backup schedule. Turn on the setting and click on the plus icon to add a schedule. Input the name of the new backup schedule. There are two types of backup schedules available, full and incremental. Create a daily backup schedule to optimize the efficiency of guest VM backup. Typically, this entails performing VM backups every day outside working hours, which also minimizes any impact on end users. When setting up a backup schedule, consider the hardware performance of the machine, the network bandwidth, and the retention policy settings. For the type setting, you can either select daily, weekly, monthly, or a custom setting. For the start backup setting, you can choose at if you want the backup schedule to start at a specified time, or every if you want it to start at a specified interval. Using regular backup intervals is crucial for ensuring that changes to the Windows guest VMs are always backed up. However, having small backup intervals also means that the backup machine must have the appropriate hardware specifications to achieve optimal performance. As the amount of new data grows, ensure that the Ahsay OBM user account has enough storage quota allocation and consider the retention policy settings and retention area storage management. For the stop setting, which is only available if you choose at, there are two options available. Until full backup completed, where the backup job will only stop running when all the changes to your backup data are completely backed up, regardless of how long it takes. and after, which stops the backup job after a specific time period, even if the backup of all your files and folders are not complete. The best practice is to enable run retention policy after backup, which will delete the files and folders in the retention area that have exceeded the retention period. This is to better manage the backup storage quota. For our example, we will create a daily backup set at 8 p.m. Click Next to proceed. Select Sequential as the backup mode since our example today only has one storage destination. However, if you have more than one destination storage, it is recommended to set the backup mode to Concurrent. Like if you want to backup your files to the Ahsay drive and a local drive. For our example, we'll save our files to the Ahsay drive. Click on the plus icon to add a destination storage. For Hyper-V backup sets, RunDirect is enabled by default. If RunDirect is enabled, the destination storage is restricted to local, map, network drive, and removable drive. Take note that both compression and encryption will be disabled for the backup set if RunDirect is enabled. Turn off RunDirect to enable the support for both compression and encryption for our backup set. This will give you the second option for the destination storage, which is to store to the Ahsay drive. Select Ahsay drive as the destination storage, click OK, then Next to proceed. Use the default setting for Granular Restore and leave it off. If Granular Restore is enabled, both compression and encryption will be disabled for the backup set. For our example, we will be encrypting our backup set. Click Next to proceed. Use the default setting for encryption. This is the most secure option as it uses Ahsay's AES 256-bit data encryption and it will randomly generate a 44 alphanumeric character encryption key to secure your backup. Remember, once you have selected the encryption settings, it cannot be changed afterwards. If you need to change the encryption settings, you will need to create a new backup set and backup all your data again. Click Next to proceed. It is very important to keep a copy of your encryption key before clicking Confirm. If you forget or lose your encryption key, you will lose the ability to access and restore your backup data. Once you have secured the encryption key, click Confirm to proceed. The temporary directory is set to a local volume by default. The temp folder is the default location where Ahsay OBN temporarily stores backup set index files and temporary restore files. The best practice is to set the temporary directory to another local drive for optimal backup and restore performance. Enable the remove temporary files after backup to effectively manage the free space on the drive. It should not be located on the same partition as the operating system, because if that drive fills up, it could cause the backup machine to crash, preventing your backup from running or completing. It shouldn't also be set to a network drive, as it could affect both backup and restore performance. Click Change and select a different location. I will select a different local drive to store the temporary files. Click Next to proceed. The backup set has been successfully created. Click Backup Now to start a backup job, or you can click Close and wait for the scheduled backup to start a backup job. Let's click Close and view the other available settings for our backup set. Click the backup set that we just created. Click on the Show Advanced Settings to view the other available settings. Click on the Duplication. The duplication is enabled by default, and when it is turned on, it removes redundant data blocks. The default settings are the optimal settings for the duplication, and for virtual machine backups, it saves up to 90% or more storage space, saves cost, and reduces network bandwidth usage. Next, select retention policy. The retention policy dictates how long it will hold files and folders that were deleted or modified during a backup job before they are removed. They are stored in the retention area, which is a temporary destination to store files and folders which can still be restored. Increasing the duration increases the likelihood of recovering older versions of deleted or modified files and folders, increasing the storage required, which translates to higher storage costs. There are two types of retention policy available. Simple, which is a basic policy where the retained files are removed automatically after a specified number of days or backup jobs. And advanced, which is a more flexible policy, which can be used to maximize the scope of your data recovery while minimizing the storage usage and cost. You can set it to daily, weekly, monthly, quarterly, yearly, or a custom setting. Let's go back and choose a simple retention policy. Next, select Others. Select the preferred compression type. You can choose between no compression, normal compression, fast compressed size larger than normal, or fast with optimization for local. We'll use the default setting, which is fast with optimization for local, as this is the optimal setting for our backup set type. Last is recycle bin. This feature allows the user to set the number of days the block files that were deleted due to retention policy or data integrity check will be held as added protection. Click Save to save the changes and go back to the main menu of Ahsay OBM. We are going to manually run a backup job. Click on the backup tile, then click on the backup set that we just created. Select the type of backup job to run, whether it's a full or incremental backup job. Enable the Run Retention Policy After Backup option to permanently delete files and folders in the retention area which have exceeded the retention period to better manage the backup storage quota. Click Backup to run a backup job. And that's how you backup virtual machines on Hyper-V standalone using Ahsay OBM. With Ahsay, your data is fully protected. Armed with the latest technology like immutable backups, where your backup data will never be encrypted, deleted, or modified for total protection against hackers and ransomware. Strong AES 256-bit data encryption ensures that your data is encrypted during transit and when your data is stored to prevent anyone from reading your data without your permission. Two-factor authentication to prevent anyone from accessing your data without your permission. Multi-destination backups to store your backup data in more than one storage destination and across many geographical regions for maximum protection against natural disasters, fire, or conflicts. And data deduplication, a feature that removes duplicate copies of data that helps you save up to 90% of your storage space, with significant savings on your data storage costs, as well as much faster backups. That's why you should choose Ahsay. Your data is safe with us.